Hi, this is Lisa.
And this is Joe.
And welcome to Cheap Date for May 6, 2006. That's Cheap Date, the show that asks the question, is it pop or soda?
Ooh, good one.
Do you care to weigh in on that?
Well, growing up in the Midwest,
it's cerveza.
Well, that's what I'm holding in my hand right now.
Happy 6 de Mayo, by the way.
Happy 6 de Mayo. Hope you're all nursing your hangovers now.
Yeah.
Well, we're not exactly sure what our condition will
be. We don't know if we're going to be hungover or not.
I am sitting here enjoying a nice Modelo Especial as we sit here.
Delicioso.
Casting. Can I say that? Casting.
No, you cannot say that.
With a little apostrophe.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, I'm just casting.
So is it pop or is it soda?
Well, having grown up in the Midwest, I can tell you that from my standpoint, it's always been pop.
Now, wait a minute. Other people say, having grown up in the Midwest, I know perfectly well that it's soda.
Actually, so that's true.
I think you need to restrict yourself. Having grown up in the Chicagoland area.
Oh, I hate that.
I know. That's why I do it.
Anyone who says Chicagoland, it's not a freaking amusement park around here, folks.
Sure.
Chicagoland or Chicagoland area. It's kind of redundant if you ask me. Having grown up in the suburbs of Chicago, we always called it pop. In fact, one of the founding families of the town where we live owned a soft drink company, a soft drink beverage company.
That's right.
And they had a store which was everyone called the Pop Shop when I was a kid.
The Pop Shop.
And they ultimately changed the name of the store to The Pop Shop. I used to go there with my parents all the time. It was very cool because you could pick out all different flavors of soda when you went there. They had grape and they had a version of 7-Up called Sparkle Up.
Sparkle Up?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
It was great.
All handcrafted right here in Arlington Heights, Illinois.
Handcrafted in Ireland. Actually, at that point, they had moved to Mount Prospect, which is the next town over. But it was still very cool. And they were in business up until the early 80s, and then they went under, and then some dude who was like a stockbroker quit his job and then started the company up again. And then about a year later, failed spectacularly. It was kind of sad because I remember seeing in the paper the bankruptcy notice for it and how a lot of the stuff was being held at auction and stuff like that. So it was kind of sad. So at that point, yeah, I think I would have been a great soft drink maker.
I think that would be, oh yeah.
Yeah, with flavors I'd come up with.
Oh, jeez.
Blue cheese soda. Buffalo jalapeno.
Mojito.
Oh yeah, now you're talking.
Uh-huh, that's a soda. I mean pop.
Now,
because I too say pop.
A friend of mine who grew up in Montgomery, Alabama, and he told me that's how you pronounce it, Montgomery, Alabama.
Okay.
Said that in the South, when you say you want a pop, that's referring to alcohol. If you want a drink, if you want a pop.
Really? So what do you say if you want a pop?
A soda.
Interesting.
Or a Coke.
Now,
the word Coke used generically.
Growing up I grew up in a couple different places, but growing up mostly in Michigan.
You grew up in all the right places. Let me put it that way. Thank you.
Here's your little rim shot.
Can you
thing.
Feel the love, ladies and gentlemen?
We've had a very lovey evening. You know, Joe and I never fight.
Yeah.
It's true. No, yet
until
no.
Now
we.
You know what?
Should we? Do we need to each do our own podcast?
I can't even
say it with a straight face.
You'd be looking for me on another label. That's right. No, I'm kidding. Go ahead. Continue your story. I'm sorry.
No, I'm out of the band. That's it. Okay. Growing up in Michigan, we always called it pop. I guess I got that from my parents who had lived in Michigan for several years prior to my being born, and prior to that had lived in Akron, Ohio and Hammond, Indiana. So I suppose I got a Chicago influence and then like an Ohio influence. Now, when you get into central Indiana, latitude-wise, it's not that far south, but you start to get the southern influence because it's also rural. Mm-hmm. So the kids there called it soda, and I took a certain amount of flack for calling it pop.
Wow.
From one person in particular.
Was pop referred to as something else, or did they just laugh at you?
No, pop didn't. They knew exactly what I meant.
But it didn't mean something else. For the way,
oh, yeah,
the way
no.
That, Lunkhead explained to me that pop meant something else.
No, or like soda. Pop. What is that? Pop. That's a sound. It's not even a word.
That's what that
yeah,
is.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. So, and then I came to Chicago, and now I say pop.
Pop. Let me have a pop.
Pop.
What kind of pop you got? You got Pepsi? You got Diet Right?
And yet I'm supposed to say Chicago.
Chicago. That's right.
Chicago.
Don't say Chicago. Then everyone knows you're not from here.
And for the love of Pete, don't say Roosevelt.
Roosevelt. That's right.
Apparently that's clue number one that you graduated at age 18 from the 8th grade.
That's right. Oh, and the other thing about here in Chicago, and you can always tell a brand new newscaster on the news of, on the TV or the radio because they all make the same mistake. There's a street that runs into the city all the way out into the suburbs, and the street is spelled D-E-V-O-N, Avenue.
Devon.
Right. And you can always tell when somebody is new to the area because they'll say that traffic is congested all the way out to Devon Avenue. And it's not Devon Avenue. It's Devon Avenue.
Devon.
That's right.
I'll tell you what, you wouldn't last a day in west of Seattle.
Why?
Because all of...
What's west of Seattle? The Pacific Ocean is west of Seattle.
No, where I used to, where I used to live.
Okay.
With all the Native American derived names.
Oh, that's true. Well, you have
Squim and Squamish.
Well, you have that in Arizona as well. You have that down there in the greater Scottsdale area as well. So, all right, well, speaking...
So why are we here today,
Well,
Joe?
Speaking of soda, as long as we were on the topic of soda and pop or whatever you want to call it, we had a little experiment on Friday night.
We thought it would be a good idea to... Actually, I'll tell you how I got this idea because I can't take credit for it. One day on NPR, they did this. Right outside NPR headquarters in Washington, D.C., they did this experiment because somehow it's generated some buzz on the internet. It's totally harmless. I do encourage you to try it at home. It'll make a mess, but it can't possibly hurt you. They went out in the backyard, and this video is available on the internet, of course. They went out in the backyard of their world headquarters, opened up a 2-liter bottle of Diet Coke, and into the 2-liter bottle of Diet Coke dumped one package of Mentos. What do you think would happen if you put an entire package of Mentos in a bottle of Diet Coke?
I would think it would just kind of maybe
Nothing.
Fizz up
a
little bit.
You would get a minty, fizzy, cokey, right. disgusting drink.
Mm-hmm.
Something happens. What happens is an 8 to 10 foot high fountain of soda.
A brown geyser.
It shoots straight up in the air for 3 glorious seconds and then stops.
Mm-hmm.
Because, of course, then all the pop is out of the bottle.
Right.
So we decided to reenact this at our local park, and we did.
And there is a video floating around, and as soon as I can figure out how to make that video available, there will be a link posted on the blog.
Now, what I think would be a great trick is to, like, walk by somebody and, like, slip a few Mentos into their soft drink.
Oh, nice. We're not encouraging you to do this, ladies and gentlemen.
No, not that you should ever, ever do that.
You get us in total trouble now.
Would it be funny in a mall food court or something?
Very cool. And from what I understand, it is the gum arabic, which is in the coating of the Mentos, and the surface area of the Mento being exposed to the soda all at once that causes the reaction.
Yeah, what it is the texture of the Mento coating. Mentos are disgusting, by the way. I just have to throw that out.
No way. They're the Freshmaker.
They're the stick your teeth together maker.
Oh, you know what? I pop those in my mouth and I just want to look around and I want to look like some sort of Nordic kid with big white teeth going, you know, giving people the thumbs up.
Doing something clever.
Oh, that's right. I need to cross the street, but I can't. Why not? Oh, the light's red. Ooh, there's a businessman in a limousine. Let me go open the door and I'll go through the car. And as I go through, I'll give him the thumbs up and he'll look at me.
Chuckle at your...
The Freshmaker.
Your youthful charm.
Mentos are the Freshmaker. Don't be dissing the Mentos.
They have never made me fresh.
They have other products.
Sounds like, sounds like a personal problem.
That's right. Oh, but we're getting away from the point of the Cheap Date Show, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi. Just two of you for dinner this evening?
Yes, just the two of us.
Right this way.
Thank you, Shelly. Do you remember the time that we went out to eat with your brother Craig and we went into the restaurant, and they said, just the three of you, and Craig said, oh, you're just going to have to do the math in your head. Is that what he said?
He didn't say that to the... Wait, I'm trying to remember.
Well, he said it to us. Was it when we went for breakfast?
Yeah, he didn't say it to anybody. He said, we had three of us, and they said, well, we'll have to get you a table for four, or... I don't remember what it was, but yeah, he said some of them you just have to do in your head. I wish I could remember because it was so funny.
But I do hate that when they just look at you, just the two of you. Well, yeah.
Unless you want to pair us up with somebody else.
All right, where is Shelly working today? You know where Shelly's working today?
Why don't you tell us, Joseph?
She's working at Big John's Gyro.
Oh, again, a place where they don't have...
Yeah, exactly. You go up to the counter, you order, and there you go.
I'd like to say there are a bunch of foods I had never had, really, before I came to Chicago. The Italian beef and Italian sausage. Pizza, of course, is a much bigger deal here. And also gyros somehow fit in there as, like, kind of an Italian sausage beef type thing.
Right.
So, what about Big John's?
Big John's is a little storefront place. If you don't know where it's at, you blow right by it. It's in a little strip center. It's a very narrow place. They have, what, 8 tables we counted in there, I think? Mm-hmm.
That sounds right.
And the cool thing about there is that there are two kinds of gyros that you can get. And we're going to forget the Arby's gyro for now. Because that I don't even know what that is. The original kind of gyros is the thing that's on the big spit. And they cut it off with a big knife. Or in the case of Big John's, they have like an electric razor.
Yeah, it's really kind of disturbing.
It is.
Now, what kind of meat is a gyro?
It's typically lamb, beef, pork, or chicken. And I think that the Chicago version, it's actually a combination of a couple of meats mixed in there.
A couple of different animals, even?
Yeah, I think so. I think it's like beef and lamb or something like that. And it's okay. I make lamb. So, yes, and it's covered with tzatziki sauce.
It's an amalgamation of meat.
Exactly. The meat is always the same. The two versions, you have the one that's on the big spit that turns. You have another thing that a lot of restaurants serve, which is like preformed strips that they fry, which is really pretty gross.
Oh, right. That's like the McDonald's version of gyros.
Right, and I've had that in some restaurants as well. So, but Big John's is awesome. They have it's truly a cheap date because they do have a special. You can get the gyro sandwich with fries and drink for under $6.50, which is really, really good.
And that's you're talking about a lot of food right there. The gyro is on pita bread with the yogurt sauce, lettuce, tomato, onion, peppers if you want them. Tell you what, my mouth tasted like gyros for 24 hours.
Easily.
After.
Yeah, a lot of garlic, a lot of...
Very spicy stuff. Not hot spicy, but very savory.
Mm-hmm. Big John's also has, they have your hot dog, they have your chili dog, your jumbo cheese dog, your Polish sausage, tuna sandwich.
Your Italian beef, your cheesy beef, and tamales.
So if you are in the area, Big John's Gyros is actually on the border of Mount Prospect and Arlington Heights, right across the street from where the Pop Shop used to be. There you go.
Oh, great. And it's a great place to go get a little quick lunch.
It is. It's centrally located between a bunch of parks and everything like that. So if you live in the area and you're running around, 1729 East Central Road, which is at Bussey. It's right next to one of our favorite pizza places, Tortorisi's, as well, which we'll get to at another show.
Okay.
So Big John's is very good. Now, we also, in our quest for fast food along those lines, we also went to another one of my favorite places that I used to go to in high school, because it's right next to the high school that I went to, which is Luke's.
Oh, yes.
It's actually called Tori and Luke's now. Luke's also has locations not only... Well, the Luke's name appears to have been spread out a bit because Luke's has restaurants all over Chicago, the Chicago area, although they also have locations in Arizona.
Oh, how about
where
that?
Where a lot of displaced Chicagoans go. They are known there... They are known for their Italian beef and Italian sausage. And what do you like there?
At Luke's, I get a pizza. Mm-hmm. Although I'm going to have to try something else next time.
Why is that?
The pizza has a very thick crust and a lot of cheese, and I prefer a pizza a little bit kind of leaner, you know, a thinner, crispier crust.
Oh, because it's kind of thick?
Yeah, the fries are really good.
Yes. The rumor when I used to go there when I was in high school is that they bought their fries in the same place McDonald's bought their fries in. The other cool thing about Luke's, and I don't know if they still do that because it's not on the menu that I'm looking at right now, but during Lent, they always had a pepper and egg sandwich as well.
Oh, yeah.
Which is, I don't know if that's a uniquely Chicago thing or if that's elsewhere.
I've never lived anywhere where restaurants made any accommodations for Lent at all. It'd be interesting to know, though, if anyone has any comments on... Because I've seen that at other Italian beef and sausage kind of places that during Lent they offer pepper and egg sandwiches.
Which is kind of a neat thing. It's a piece of Italian bread with scrambled eggs and pepper in it.
Like chopped up pepper?
Yeah.
Like a little like scramble? Minced,
right. Like one of your veggie scramblers only on a piece of French bread.
Aw.
Fascinating. There we go. And while we're on this, so that's Luke's. They have, according to this menu, they have two locations, which must be the two owned by this particular franchisee. One at 1350 Rand Road in Arlington Heights, which is right by the Target.
And then there's by John Hersey.
Right by Hersey High School. And then there's another one up in Palatine. My Modelo is almost gone, honey.
Uno más?
You know what? Oh, see, I'll fall. Now I'll fall asleep.
Oh, well, we can't have that.
I don't want to be falling asleep on you.
Mm-hmm. Heaven forbid. Okay, so we covered a couple.
It was very convincing, honey. Oh, heaven forbid.
You never fall asleep on me. I always fall asleep on you.
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
Okay, so we covered Luke's and Big John's. Two good little places to go get lunch or quick dinner.
Mm-hmm. Kids liked it. Kid friendly.
Yeah, you got your hot dogs and your hamburgers, your fries, your tamales. Good stuff.
You name it, baby.
Good, like, just good normal people food.
Good normal fried, man.
The kind of food that's going to clog up your arteries.
Mm-hmm.
You'll want to go home and have a salad after either of these places.
You're right, you will.
Spinach stat. Clear out the arteries.
So once again, thanks to everyone for the comments on the weblog. Thanks for all the emails.
Let us know what you call carbonated soft drinks in your neck of the woods.
Mm-hmm.
We may or may not talk further about it. How many shows in a row have we talked about pop?
I don't know,
like
several.
8.
I think maybe we need to start talking about beer. Ooh. Subject close to your heart, let me tell you.
Okay, that's enough of that.
Okay.
I wonder if you put Mentos in beer.
Let's try that after the show.
Whoa.
Dude.
Check this out. What a waste of beer.
I know. Send us your comments at...
dish@cheapdateshow.com.
And you can visit our blog at cheapdateshow.com. And also, if you... Don't forget, you can subscribe to us through iTunes.
Of course.
We are there. We keep bouncing in and out of the top 100 food podcasts.
Yeah, so, like, subscribe, all right? So subscribe. Get us in the top 100.
That's someone coming in from a vacation at O'Hare Airport, ladies and gentlemen.
To Chicago O'Hare Airport.
Listen to that. It's right overhead. It's one of the cool things about living here is I can always tell which way the wind is blowing depending on what the takeoff and landing patterns are. Because sometimes we'll go for days without hearing an airplane and then all of a sudden it'll be something like that. Plus all the windows are open too, so.
Wow.
Imagine that, honey.
Well, that's going to wrap it up for tonight.
Okay. Happy Cinco de Mayo, everybody. Enjoy a cerveza. Enjoy some nachos. Make yourself a dang quesadilla.
All right. Good night.
Good night. You know you're beautiful.
This podcast is proudly listed at podcastpickle.com. rock. Get these spiders off me!
Rhythm, huh?
How's that? Oh,
Jaylor, I hate acapella.
Oh, so that's who I am.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
Say.
I think I'll take after him with that hammer.
Shut up! Shut up! Shut up!
Mr. Smith.
Did I do something last night? I'm not going to be proud.
Guys have had their heads chopped off for less than that. For what?
For singing and singing and singing and singing and singing.
Well, doggone good when I feel so bad. How'd I get here anyway? I told you in this morning, remember?
I told you, but I left the car.
I remember very, very little.
But don't worry, you're a perfect gentleman.
I haven't seen any other cars. How'd you ever get me in that bed anyway?
Who was your cologne?
I carried you in there and I sat on you till you fell asleep.
Oh, wow.
That must have been quite a chore. You wouldn't have gotten very far in your condition.
It was fun. I didn't
from
mind.
I really appreciate it. Chase Winstead. Chase. Right. And I, by golly, how much owe you?
Well, I bent the fender out from the wheel. Want me to fill it in and touch it up for you?
You've touched it, Chase.
No, I don't think so. I'll get that done when I get back to the city.
Yogurt?
Here, have some coffee. Oh, great. How about $2?
$2? That's outrageous. I'm not paying.
Man, this coffee's worth $2 all by itself. How about the toe?
No, I was coming this way anyway. I missed out on a little studying time. Make it $3?
Kid, you're dumber than a bag of hammers.
Sort of. I take a correspondence course in engineering.
Leg up.
Mine City Votech.
I really feel indebted to you, and I'd like to do something to pay you back. Now, next time you're in the town, there's my card. Look me up, will you?
Right. Will do.
Okay. On, by the way.
Here's a Denny's coupon. Good any time after midnight. Enjoy.
Buy yourself a sponge rubber hammer, man. All right, I will. I'll see you, Chase.
Hammer man.
Thank you.
No, thank you.
Oh, no, thank you.
No, thank you.
No, no, please, thank you.
No.
Steamroller Smith, the disc jockey.
Hey, I love your morning show, especially when you make goofy phone calls to celebrities.
220.
That makes $30. Wow.